Running a Content RAS application is easy if you're just running it on localhost or your development machine. But making it available for everyone by deploying the app into the cloud, well, that's another story. You need to identify which services that you need to use, how to use them, as well as configuring those services before you can actually deploy your application. So today, let me show you a cool stuff on how you can deploy your app easily into Amazon ECS and AWS Fargate using AWS Copilot. This is a simple Hello World application that shows a few information of the running system. And I have this app running on my local host, and I want to deploy this Hello World app into Amazon ECS and AWS Fargate. And I'm going to use a tool called AWS Copilot. So if I run this command, Copilot Service Deploy, it will deploy my containerized applications into Amazon ECS running on AWS Fargate behind an application load balancer. And I can access it by visiting the URL. So today, I will introduce you to AWS Copilot, how to get started with a step-by-step walkthrough on how you can deploy your first containerized application. Hello everyone, welcome back to Dev Workshop, where demo comes first and how comes second. As always, I'm going to show you practical information on how you can develop apps with AWS Cloud. So first thing first, Copilot is a CLI tool, not a service. It abstracts away the complexities of provisioning resources and deploying your application. So let me give you an example. Suppose that you have an application ready with Dockerfile and need to deploy it using container orchestrators. To have a highly scalable app means that you need to be able to scale it based on the demand. And you also want to have a reliable application, meaning that it needs to be up and running the whole time to serve your customers. And translating this to technical architecture, this is roughly what you need to get started. You need a computing resources to host your containerized application. And you also need to have an orchestrator to manage everything. Then you also need a load balancer to help distribute the request to your application. And mapping these requirements with AWS services, you can use Amazon ECS as your container orchestrator and AWS Fargate as serverless computing resources and application load balancer as the load balancer. You also need to have VPC along with proper networking and configuration and hosting the image of your apps with Amazon ECR. And this is exactly what Copilot can help you with. It is a tool that abstracts away the complexity for all of those tasks that you need to prepare and execute to deploy your application. So let's deploy our Hello World app and see Copilot in action. Just a quick overview of the application. This is the application that we'd like to deploy. And this is the source code of the application. Nothing fancy about this. It's written on Python and using Flask framework. I also have a Docker file for the application. You can also check out the GitHub repo in case that you want to play with it. Now, to deploy this application using Copilot, the first thing that we need to do is to initialize the application. Then, Copilot will guide us with a series of questions, and it asks which type of the workload or service that we want to deploy. Okay, so let's stop here, and let me share with you a quick overview on each of these types, since it's really important for you to pick the right type of service. So there are a few types that you can see on the screen. Request-driven web service, load balance web service, backend service, worker service, and scheduler job. So just a quick overview on each of these types. If you have a service with low requests or need to manage burst requests, choose request-driven web service. This will create a service running on AWS App Runner, which I have covered in other video. If you want to have a service equipped with a load balancer and public endpoint that you can access to, then choose load balance web service. In most cases, you will need this type of service. If you need a private service that you can only access within your application, then you will need a backend service. Worker service is more to implementation of asynchronous communication with PubSub for microservices architecture. So I use worker service quite often, and I have included this pattern in most of my workshop as I found it really powerful and easy to implement to handle asynchronous communication for most use cases. I will definitely cover this in other video. Then scheduled job. So this is not part of a service actually, but more to jobs that could be triggered by an event or schedule. As we are building a web application, I'm going to choose load balance web service. So let's pick that option. Then we need to add more details to complete this process and choose the right Docker file for the application. When it's done, it's going to ask us to create a test environment. If you choose yes, Copilot will go ahead creating a new environment for you and deploy the apps into that particular environment. For this demo, I'm going to skip this part as I want to show you a few important parts before we actually deploy the application. Once the Copilot finishes the init process, it will create files for us. And these files are the implementation of Infrastructure as Code or IAC, and it's actually the magic on how Copilot could provision all those resources for us. So let's take a look into the file. This is the manifest file for our Hello World app. We have named it as web with load balance web service as the type. You can also control the path to forward the request to your application by defining the HTTP directive. You also have the flexibility to control the port, the CPU, memory, how many tasks that you want to run, as well as the environment variables. It looks like everything is in place, so I don't need to change anything. Just remember that you have the flexibility to configure your service. Once that you're happy with the configuration, we need to create the environment. All services that you're going to deploy with Copilot needs an environment to live in. And this is one of the best practices embedded into AWS Copilot, as it helps us to isolate all the services that we have so it will not interfere one to another. To create an environment, all you need to do is to execute Copilot env init. As always, Copilot will guide you by asking series of questions to help you finish this process. As you see in the completed processes, Copilot created IAM role, cluster, security groups, and internet gateway, two private subnets, and two public subnets within a VPC. This is one of the best practices when it comes to architecting your application that is already baked inside Copilot. Now we have the application and the environment. We are ready to deploy the application. To deploy the application, what we need to do is just to run Copilot service deploy. Since we only have one service and one environment, Copilot will use them as a default. If you have multiple services and environments, you need to specify each of them. Okay, so it's deployed now. To test the application, the first thing that we need to do is to get the URL. You can see that we have the URL once we have deployed the application. Another way is that we can run Copilot service show command and Copilot will provide us with all details. It's really amazing on how easy it is to deploy the application with Copilot. Okay, now let's open this URL on the browser. Cool, it works. And that is how you deploy your app with Copilot. Sometimes you also want to see the logs of your applications. And to do this, you can run Copilot service logs. With Copilot service logs command, along with flag follow, it will show you the latest logs of your application. And you are probably wondering, what are the resources created by Copilot? So there are two ways on doing this. First is by going to CloudFormation console and click on the tab resources for that specific stack. The other way, and this is how I prefer to see everything, is by running Copilot service show with flag resources. It will show all of those resources created by Copilot to run the application. And lastly, if you no longer need the application, you can run Copilot app delete and it will remove everything. This video only provides a quick introduction about AWS Copilot. And obviously, there are more features that you can use to build your app with Copilot. From creating multiple isolated environments, adding database, integrate with Amazon S3 to implement PubSub. So stay tuned for more videos on this channel to learn how to utilize Copilot. So all in all, I found Copilot is the best tool yet to deploy applications to Amazon ECS and AWS Fargate. No matter if you are building a single application or if you want to extend your apps into more complex architecture like microservices, AWS Copilot can definitely help you. If you want to learn more about AWS Copilot, I have also published a website called Copilot Rocks that documents all of my learnings to build architectural patterns like PubSub, Service Discovery to Saga patterns using AWS Copilot, complete with source code and step-by-step guide. So that's all for now. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. I'm Donnie and happy building!